Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week number 41. This week I'm post-processing a photo of a skyscraper that I shot while in New York City. I exposed for the shadows and not the highlights. So because I shoot in RAW, I will be able to recapture the highlights that are slightly or somewhat blown out in the photo. So I'm going to begin first by decreasing the exposure, and you'll see what that brings in a lot of the highlights. From there, I am going to, strangely enough, I'm going to decrease the highlights, and I'm going to open up the shadows, and then I am going to set my white point. I'm going to bring it up to about here, and if you hold your option key down and slide the slider to the right, when you get to a point where you've got some color in the screen, you can let go and you will have set a white point. Same with the black. I'm going to move it here. I'm keeping a little bit more black in it. And then I'm going to hit the clarity button. I'm going to bring that up to about here. Vibrance, I am going to leave where it is. Saturation, though the sky was amazingly blue that day, I'm going to bring it down just a little bit to about here. Then I'm going to come down into my lens correction panel, and I am going to into the basics, and I'm going to enable profile correction, and you'll see what that did. Let me go back and show you before. And there you go. And then I'm going to remove any chromatic aberration. And then I'm going to come into upright perspective and click auto. And it deals with the, it corrects the perspective of the photo. And since I'm staring up at a very tall building, this helps to bring it back into lines, so to speak. Now at this point, I am done with this with the Lightroom edit, and now I want to bring this into my favorite program, Color Effects Pro. So I'm going to edit in and come over here to the program I have loaded into Lightroom, Color Effects Pro. And it's going to create a TIFF folder or TIFF file down in my timeline down here, and as it does, you will see it pop up. There we go. It is blank, and it will, once I make my edits in Color Effects Pro, it will sync those changes back to that file. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to exit out. I'm going to come back to the list of filters, and I'm going to come over to Pro Contrast and click on the stack here to bring up the different levels of filters. I usually use preset number 3, and I will show you before and after. If I toggle that off, you see that it just makes the image pop. I like where the sliders are. I could change them if I wanted to change the effect of the filter, but I like it where it is. So now I'm going to add another filter, and that's another favorite of mine, dark and light and center. Click on the stack, and I will go to the default. And again, here's the before and after. You can see it just it adds, it's basically a vignetting, but it does it in a much nicer, more subtle way than Lightroom does. And I can also choose to place the center. The center is basically in the center of the photo, but I can choose to place it somewhere differently. Now I'm going to play with this. I'm going to move this up a bit. There we go. If you see where I just, let me go into history, by changing where the center was, it highlighted the top of the building more. So there it was before, and then when I shifted the center, it brought more light to the top of the building, which is where I want your eyes to go. At this point, I am going to save, and it's going to bring this back into Lightroom. And then the last thing I'm going to do, because I forgot to do that before I brought it into Color Effects Pro, I'm going to actually add a post-crop vignette. Actually, I'll come over here to my user presets, just a slight one. Okay, and the last thing I do is noise reduction, and Nick Effects has a great noise reduction program called Define, which I like to use. So edit in, I'm going to come Define 2. Again, it's going to create, I'm going to edit a copy with Lightroom adjustments. Again, it's going to create another TIFF file. But what I love about this program is that it's pretty darn accurate in what it samples to get rid of noise. And you can see that it's working. It's an automatic reduction. These boxes here are areas from which noise has been sampled. And there's a lot of boxes around here. And you can see, let's see if I go to the single view. I don't know if you'll be able to see. And in fact, it's hard for me to see on this screen as it is. But if you look down at the loop view and toggle, you can see that it has taken out quite a bit of noise. So I'm going to hit save, and it will bring it back into Lightroom. Slowly but surely. And there's the final image. Let's go back to the before. Let me find the original file. There's the before, and there's the after. I think it's better. What do you guys think? I hope you've enjoyed the video. For those of you watching on YouTube, if you want to see more galleries of after, before photos, please visit my website, visualventuring.com, and look for After Before Friday Forum. Please leave comments either on my blog or on my YouTube page. And as always, everyone, thanks for watching.